Tracking violence in Minneapolis and the weapons that were used. Look at this map. In the past 72 hours, these three incidents that we've reported here on Sunrise involve some guns configured to fire fully automatic. That's according to police. A shooting near the 4th Precinct, a 14-year-old shot on the north side, and the triple shooting yesterday morning in downtown.
CeCe's in the newsroom now looking into how officials are cracking down on these weapons. CeCe?
Yes, good morning. City data shows that to date there have been over 5,500 reported shots fired calls, and officials say many of those involved automatic weapons, as you mentioned. They say this is happening because more people are getting their hands on conversion devices called auto sears. Take a look at this. This is the tool. It's no bigger than a nickel. People are clipping it to the back of their handgun, and it goes from a semi-automatic gun to a fully automatic weapon. The St. Paul division of the ATF says they're seeing more young people using them, and that's why investigators are finding 100 or more shell casings at crime scenes. They say many of these devices are coming from overseas, but others are being made right here using 3D printing.
Any device that somebody wants to possess, they have to register, and they go to ATF to do that. So when we see criminals in possession of these auto sears, we know that they're automatically illegal, and it's a federal offense.
ATF agents say they've already made dozens of arrests linked to gun violence this year across the Twin Cities. Coming up in about 30 minutes, we hear from a local group that's looking to change the narrative surrounding gun violence in Minneapolis.